Now let us discuss about induction potentiometers. So these are the linear synchro devices which provide an accurate measurement of the shaft rotation about a reference position in the form of voltage whose magnitude is proportional to the angular displacement, and the phase relationship indicates the direction of shaft rotation. Here, these are the linear synchro devices basically used for the measurement of angular displacement. So now, it consists of a rotor attached to the transmitting shaft on which the primary winding is wound, and its stator is wound with secondary winding. These two windings are so designed that the output voltage across the secondary stator winding is directly proportional to the angular position of the rotor. So as the rotor rotates, as the angular position of the rotor theta increases with respect to its reference position, then the output voltage generated across the stator winding also increases. So in this way, this induction potentiometer is basically used, it can be used for the measurement of angular displacement in terms of output voltage generated across the stator winding. But here, there are some errors that can arise in this measurement by means of induction potentiometer. One is the mechanical asymmetry. So this induction potentiometer should be symmetrical. It should be symmetrically structured. If there is an asymmetry, then there may be error in the measurement. So the theta may not correspond to the generation of voltage across the stator winding. And the second error is variable output impedance. So the output impedance is variable here. If there is a variable output impedance, it may cause error in the measurement. And thermal effects. So as the temperature of the windings increase, it may cause error in the measurement. So these are some of the errors that may occur during the measurement in case of induction potentiometers. Now let us discuss about synchros and resolvers. Basically, these synchros and resolvers are a class of AC electromechanical variable coupling transformer devices. And these synchros and resolvers are basically used for angular data transmission. So let us see first synchros. So this is the basic diagram of a common synchro. So its basic structure of a synchro consists of a wound rotor and a wound stator. They are mutually coupled to each other. The rotor is wound with a single phase concentrated winding, and the stator is wound with three phase distributed windings connected in star configuration. So now the rotor is excited with an single phase AC signal, and by the transformer action between rotor and stator windings, voltages are induced in the stator coils. And the magnitudes of these voltages depend upon the angular position of the stator, the angular position of the rotor with respect to stator. So now, here a pair of synchros are used. One acts as a transmitter and another acts as a receiver. So whenever the rotor position is displaced, whenever there is an angular displacement of the rotor, certain amount of voltage is generated across the stator winding, that is transmitter. So this voltage signal can be transmitted to another stator winding, so another stator coil. So voltage is received by another stator coil. So in this case, the angular displacement is transmitted from transmitter to receiver over a long distance in terms of the voltage signal. So this is how angular data transmission can be achieved in case of synchros. Now let us see resolver. So an inductive resolver is a variable transformer with electromagnetic coupling between a primary and secondary windings. So in case of a typical resolver, the two windings are provided at right angles to one another for both stator as well as rotor. The windings are located in such a manner that the output voltage generated has an amplitude proportional to sine or cosine of the input shaft position of the rotor with respect to stator. So in this case, the output voltage developed across the stator is equal to sine or cosine of the angle between the shaft position of the rotor with respect to stator. So initially it is 90 degree, and as the rotor rotates, so this angle also increases or decreases. So as theta increases or decreases, depending upon that, the output voltage is generated across stator. And this stator voltage is transmitted to another set of stator rotor combination. So this stator voltage is transmitted to another stator by means of magnetic coupling. So therefore, this type of angular data transmission is possible with the help of resolver. So it transmits the angular displacement in terms of stator voltage, and that stator voltage is transmitted to another stator winding. So therefore, here the angular data transmission is done. So as the theta increases or decreases, the stator voltage which is obtained across the second stator or secondary stator increases or decreases. So this is the data transmission or angular data transmission by means of resolver. So now let us see the advantages of synchros and resolvers. So here synchros and resolvers are advantageous because they have got high reliability, high accuracy, infinite resolution, and no rotational wear. There is no rotational wear here because we are going to transmit the electrical signal from primary winding to secondary winding or from transmitter to receiver. So therefore, there is no question of wear here. And the operational speeds of the system are very high.